Hello, I want to welcome you to Tehran and thank you for taking part in this interview. Would you please introduce yourself?
My name is E. Michael Jones. I'm the editor of Culture Wars magazine.
And we're coming here for Hollywoodism conference.
Yes, I spoke at the Hollywoodism conference this morning. I'll be here all week at the conference.
Do you think Zionism have the main role in Hollywood?
Well, let's back up a little bit. There were two revolutionary Jewish ideologies in Russia during the 19th century. One was Zionism and one was communism. And both of these groups came over to America, and traditionally the Jews in Hollywood are more oriented toward communism than they are toward Zionism. I think that's still true today, that the neoconservatives in New York are more Zionist in their orientation, and the Jews in Hollywood are more left-wing Marxist or Reichian in their interpretation of things.
What do you think about United States of America's economic crisis? Does it continue or it will be stopped by Obama's policy?
No, he cannot stop it. It's systemic. The problem, economic problem, is systemic. It's based on usury, the compound interest that accrues from loans. Now, this is one area where the Islamic world is superior to the West because they created a banking system that does not make use of usury. Usury and compound interest will, over the long haul, destroy every economy, and no one can stop it. The only thing you can do, there are two options, generally, it's theft or debasing the currency, and they'll probably try both, but eventually it's going to collapse.
And do you think, does it have any relationship with Middle East wars? I mean, United States takes part in Middle East war, for example, supporting anti-government movement in Syria, such a thing?
The involvement in the Middle East was largely the result of neoconservative Jewish influence on our foreign policy, and in many ways it contradicted our oil interests. This is the problem with supporting Israel. It contradicts our interest in getting oil out of the country. It's kind of complicated. It's easier to see, I think, in the United States intervention in Africa. The AFRICOM intervention in all these African countries is for mineral resources. They're trying to take the mineral resources for the United States and block the Chinese from having access to them.
What do you think? What will happen to economic crisis in the United States of America?
We have a debt that is unrepayable. They will try, short-term solution will be to debase the currency. In other words, to inflate the currency so that you have more dollars, but that will just ruin the economy. So there are no solutions to this problem. There are no solutions over the long haul.
What do you think? Why the U.S. government does not take the secession petition of states seriously? Why they don't reply seriously to these state secession petitions?
I didn't understand that.
The state secession petitions.
You mean why don't the states secede in the United States? Have you heard of the Civil War? That's what happened when they tried to secede. They were all destroyed.
Why? Texas? Why the government, U.S. government, does not take seriously about the secede? They don't reply it. For example, in Texas, they have signed 120,000 signs.
Because they saw what happened to the South when they seceded. It will mean the civil war and they will be destroyed. They will be destroyed militarily. It's not an option. It's not a serious option.
For the government.
No, it's not a serious option. That ended with the civil war.
What do you think? Does it continue? I mean, the signs of secede?
No.
In other states?
No, I don't think it's realistic. I don't think anybody takes it seriously.
Why?
It's a joke. Because of the Civil War. That set a precedent. You cannot secede from the United States. It's forever. You're never going to get out again. Everybody knows that now. So it's not serious.
Thank you very much for taking part.